My name is Veronica Addis. I'm an OBGYN here in New York. I just returned from the field. I was in Awil, South Sudan. I was there from February to March of this year, 2016. I was at this project in 2012 in Awil, and I saw huge differences. The project at that time was really still in the process of being established. The staff had less training. They didn't have as much ability to operate independently. But now the staff, many of them are very experienced. They're midwives and nurses. They come having graduated from midwifery school, nursing school. Many of them graduated in South Sudan, which is a source of pride. And they can do deliveries on their own, including complicated deliveries like breech deliveries, twin deliveries. Some of them are recent graduates and still need some guidance, but many of them have been working with MSF for 2, 3, or 4 years. And they call us for obstetrically complicated things, but otherwise really can operate independently. And that's really wonderful to see. So a lot of the deliveries we end up seeing are very complicated by definition. They come in late. We hope we're getting the word out that women should come earlier, and the proportion of complications will go down because we hope that they'll show up maybe after 1 day of labor instead of 4. There were a lot of sad stories and there were still deaths while I was there, but there were also women who came for help at the right time. There was one success story that I was really happy about. It was a woman who came at the right time, and she had lost 3 previous pregnancies as stillbirth. She was very, very concerned it was going to happen again, and she was sort of seeming to indicate that she wanted a C-section. But from my perspective, I don't want to do a C-section for no reason, and I wanted to really know whether she could deliver vaginally. When I talked to her further, it really sounded like her water broke, and she never came in for 3, 4, 5 days. And usually you develop an infection if your labor doesn't come after your water breaks. And so what I offered her instead of a C-section was an induction of labor. I could give her medicine to cause the contractions to come and she would deliver, and she agreed. And about a day later, she had a healthy baby. You know, we were all thrilled. And it was the fact that we were there, that she was able to come in, that she knew the MSF name, and she'd heard from other people that MSF was there to help her. And it was really, really rewarding in the face of so much sadness and so many complicated deliveries to have like this one happiness, to have this really kind of, from my perspective, easy thing that I could do. But for her, it was a really huge deal that I had this medical knowledge, that I had this understanding of obstetrics to know why her babies had died, that I could just give her a simple medicine and then make her labor start. So that was just really, really thrilling.